Hey there guys, welcome back to another video. So today we'll be unboxing an affordable all-in-one PC for under $600. And this here is the 2022 Lenovo IdeaCentre AIO 3 24-inch all-in-one desktop PC. And this is the AMD version. It is using the Ryzen 5 5500 processor with integrated AMD Radeon graphics card. Let's go ahead and dive right into the unboxing. So this comes in a pretty big box, and the first box inside this big box contains the power supply. The end that connects to the back of your PC looks like a USB-A connection. You also find the cable that connects to the AC adapter and to the wall. They also threw in a cable management clip to help tidy up your desk, and that's pretty nice. The next box in here has the keyboard and mouse combo. The mouse that it comes with does not have side buttons to go back and forward, which is a bummer. Don't get me wrong, it's a good mouse, but I would recommend spending some money on a mouse with side buttons. The mouse is powered by two AA batteries, and on the bottom you got the on and off switch. The top portion of the mouse comes off, and this is where the USB receiver is located. It uses a single receiver to connect your keyboard and the mouse to your computer. Now going on to the next box, this one contains the keyboard, and you got a full keyboard layout. It has shortcuts on the top row, like the volume and play and pause, that you can quickly access by holding down the FN key while pressing the desired shortcut that you want. On the back, you'll find the little foldable legs to raise the keyboard. Now, if you pop this part open here, you will see a slot for the USB receiver on the left side here, so you can put the receiver in either the mouse or the keyboard, which is pretty nice. And on the right side, you got the slot to slide in the AA batteries to power the keyboard. So this comes with all four AA batteries that you will need, two for the keyboard and two for the mouse, so that's great. So this is a nice looking keyboard that is comfortable and it's very responsive and quiet. Now to the PC and monitor itself. This comes really well packaged. You got that thick foam protecting your screen. So I really like the design of this. It has a modern and slim look. The backside reveals a very thin metal arm that connects the base to the computer. This lets you pivot your computer forwards and back, but you can't swivel it side to side. You will need to move the entire computer to make that adjustment. So even though this is made primarily from plastic, it doesn't look cheap. It has a solid build quality. This has a very nice base and it gives you a spot to put some small items on, and there's a small indentation that runs across it that will help you prop your phone up. This has a 24-inch 60Hz display with a resolution of 1920x1080p. The text shows up nice and sharp, and the colors on here are also good. This has a good amount of saturations that makes the colors pop, and it makes it enjoyable to watch movies and YouTube videos on here. So on the top here, it has a 720p webcam that can be pulled up when you need it and tucked away when you are done with it, and that is pretty nice. But the quality is not great. Now it is a little high, so you will need to angle the monitor downwards to capture you well. I would highly recommend you purchase a 1080p webcam if you really need to use a webcam. So this has four USB ports on the back, which is enough to get you started and hook up a keyboard, a mouse, and a microphone. The cool thing is that the mouse and keyboard only take up one slot. Now I would recommend investing in a USB hub to get access to more peripherals, because this will fill up very quickly as time goes by. So a great thing about this upgraded 2022 model is that it now features an HDMI out port. This allows you to hook it up to an external display and have a dual monitor setup. And this will likely improve your productivity flow. So on the back here, you'll find the Ethernet port in case you want to connect it directly to your router instead of using Wi-Fi. Now, for those of you worried about the performance of the AMD CPU compared to the Intel version, worry not. AMD offers one of the best affordable processors that money can buy without sacrificing performance. I'm actually running an AMD CPU on my personal computer, so I can attest to that. The AMD 5500U CPU is found mostly on laptops, and here's a benchmark of where it lies in comparison to Intel's laptop CPU. So you are getting better performance than the Intel i7-1075H processor. Now, if you plan on doing some heavy gaming on this computer, you'll find that this is not that great for that. Although this has a powerful and capable CPU, it does not have a beefy graphics card. So I pulled up Apex Legends just for the fun of it and lowered all the graphics settings to low and set the resolution to 720p, and it was not a pleasant experience. The game felt very unresponsive and sluggish. Now, if you plan on doing some very light gaming with games that don't require a powerful graphics card, then this will do great. So a downside on this all-in-one computer is that it only comes with 256GB of storage. If you're going to be downloading a bunch of apps and games, then this will fill up very quickly. Now the upside is that this allows you to expand the storage in a clever way. On the bottom of the screen, there is an SSD bracket that slides out where you can add an additional SSD to expand the storage. So this comes with built-in speakers that actually sound good. You get a full and clear audio. Now the sound will distort when you take it to max volume, and the sound will sound very high-pitched. I don't go past 70% and it sounds good to me. You can always upgrade this in the future by buying a set of speakers, but for most of you, this will do just fine. Now here's a quick audio sample just so you can get a feeling of what this sounds like. Overall, this computer is a great choice for students and for those mainly using Microsoft apps and relying on the web to get your job done. Alright, so thank you all for watching. If you found the video helpful, feel free to smash that like button and subscribe for more tech videos, and I will talk to you on the next one.